Devils taking the field here, getting ready for kickoff tonight against the Hobbton Wildcats. Hobbton has won the opening toss and will defer until the second half, so the Maroon Devils will get the football first on offense, and let's see if we can set the tone early before a great crowd of Maroon Devil fans here tonight. Hobbton, a few empty seats on the other side tonight in this state 1A playoff contest.
White and Anthony Stevenson.
Okay, guys, here we go in 3, 2, 1. Hi, everybody. Welcome to another Swain County High School football playoff contest here at Swain County Memorial Stadium in Boysteets Field. Our Maroon Devils take on a team we have a history with, the Hobbton Wildcats. We'll talk more about that as the game continues tonight, as the Wildcats have won the toss and have deferred until the second half. They will kick it off to our Maroon Devils. Hobbton, very obvious who these guys are, and they're black and white. And here we go. The opening kick is going to be down to the 12-yard line, almost running into each other. The Maroon Devils bring it back across the 25, out to the 29-yard line. That's where the Devils will take over now, first and 10. And again, thanks for tuning in here on Hometown Television tonight as we're ready to go for another great round of playoff activity. As we mentioned, this marks the third meeting between the Hobbton Wildcats and the Maroon Devils. We have never beaten Hobbton High School. We lost 26-21 in the second round of the state playoffs 2 years ago. And then back in 1993, Hobbton beat us in the 1A state championship game 20-12. Tonight, revenge on the mind of these guys in maroon and white. Hand off to the right side. There's a big hole for Cody White. Cody White has a first down and then some, all the way out to the 44-yard line. And that's what we were hoping for. Our Maroon Devils have set the stage early and have come up with a first down. And Hobbton, with a player slow getting up off the field as Jawan Fison gets up slowly. And this Maroon Devil crowd, highly partisan here tonight. And we outnumber the other side by hundreds to one almost here at Swain County Memorial Stadium tonight. We're just underway in the first quarter, and we have a player who's still shaken up. He was slow getting up. That's Jawan Fison, looks like, and he's going to be leaving the field here tonight after he was shaken up. So we have a brief break in the action here. Maroon Devils with a first down and 10 here, just underway on the first play from scrimmage, the only play from scrimmage we have had here in the first quarter against the Hobbton Wildcats. Right now they have four linemen up front, basically a 3-4 defense. Three down linemen, two linebackers, one on each side as the Devils line up on the eye. And another huge hole right up the middle, just over the right side, down to the 48-yard line of Hobbton as the Devils stay on the ground and do so very, very successfully on second down, on the first down play here, as the Maroon Devils now had two running plays and almost two first downs. 9-yard gain there on first down. Second down and one coming up for the Maroon Devils as we're moving from left to right, if you will, with 10:51 to play in the first quarter. The Devils setting the tone early with a running game. Hand off to the left side again, and with a first down and four more yards is going to be Cody White as he cracks the left side down to the 42-yard line of Hobbton. Now, we have played one team of Wildcats already this year, but believe me, this team of Wildcats has teeth. The first group of Wildcats we played at Andrews this year, no teeth in that football game. But tonight, the Hobbton Wildcats will see if they can do something nobody has done in the playoffs, and that score, much less win. Nobody has scored against the Devils in state playoff activity so far, and for the first time tonight, Hobbton stops our Maroon Devils on offense. Scotty McNahan stopped on the play. No gain at the 42-yard line as he started to the right side with the option. Just over 10 minutes to play here. We're in the first quarter, a nice, cool, mountain-style football night as far as weather goes. So it's the kind of night that Maroon Devil fans like. We think it's kind of an advantage, if you will, playing mountain-style football. I know in Coach Rod White's speech to the players before last week's game at Chatham Central here at Swain County, he talked about the mountain style that these guys play. And here's a nice toss to the left side. Out to the left side is going to be Scotty McMahon tossing out there to Cody White. And good hitting by Hobbton, but they hit the wrong guy as Scotty again ran the option to the left side. now at the 39-yard line. All of a sudden, after an easy first down on the first play and the second first down also fairly easy, now the Maroon Devils facing a third down and almost seven as we have twins, Josh Anthony and Justin Evans. Scotty wants to throw, has his man at the 35-yard line. Down inside the 30-yard line is going to be Josh Anthony. Josh, 26 catches this year, averaging 20 yards a catch this year for the Maroon Devils here with 9:08 to go in the first quarter. And the Devils keep moving the chains on the opening drive. That one good for 11 yards, a first down and then some. And again, we're talking about the first downs of Josh Anthony and Justin Evans, key members of this offense. Handoff goes to the left side. This time it's going to be Eric Stevenson on the carry down to the 20-yard line. You see that kind of a red stripe as we enter the red zone. Very close to another Maroon Devil first down, but just about a yard shy here. 8:38 to go in the first quarter of play. Maroon Devils have taken the opening kickoff and moved it all the way to the 20-yard line of the Hobbton Wildcats. Hobbton coming in the number 4 seed in the West bracket. Of course, our Maroon Devils are the number 1 seed, and that's why we're playing here at home. The Devils 11-0, Hobbton coming in 9-3. Both teams very strong offensively, but the Maroon Devils, we think, are probably with an edge on defense. Throwing in the corner of the end zone. Down there, it's in. Is it a touchdown? Yes, Maroon Devils get on the scoreboard. We're talking about the receiving capability of Josh Anthony. Scotty McMahon aired it out. Good timing, good catch, and the Devils draw first blood with 8:11 to play. And our score now, 6-0. Touchdown efforts as well. His kick is up, and it's going to be good. So fans, 8:11 to play in the first quarter, and our Maroon Devils have set the tone in this football game. 7-0 over the Hobbton Wildcats. Welcome back, fans, as Nick Zimmerman will kick it off again for the Maroon Devils, and we'll tell you some about his stats in just a moment as he kicks it. This one more of a line drive, not a typical Zimmerman kick. It's going to be taken at the 10-yard line. Back to the 20, trying to find some room, and does around the left side. Nice return over there by Juwan Fison. So facing out to the 26-yard line. Talking about Nick Zimmerman, Swain High kicker Nick Zimmerman now has 45 touchbacks on the year out of 73 total kickoffs. That's 62% of his kicks not going in the end zone. 8 have been played on the 1-yard line. And 16 times the Maroon Devil kicking team has pinned the opponent inside the 20-yard line to start their drives. That is a great, great weapon. Have a timeout on the field. So after the timeout, Faison leaves the ball game. He's been shaken up a couple of times tonight, and a lot of guys have been shaken up by the Devils this year. Airing it out on the first play. There was some contact, but that was really not a catchable pass down at the Maroon Devil 45-yard line. We talked about this in the pregame with Toby Burrell. The element of speed, if there is an advantage Hobbton has, it's in that department, is speed. And our Maroon Devils and basically every team from the mountains, unless you're Asheville or T.C. Robertson, most mountain teams don't have a lot of speed, and that's the only advantage that we can see right now early in the ball game that Hobbton has. And as you know, speed can be a big advantage, but if our Devils play technique football, stay in their lanes, we can nullify some of that speed. Head up to the right side, and again, there's good technique football on defense as the runner is stopped just across the 25-yard line for a loss on the play. And that's going to bring up third down and over 10 to go for Hobbton, with 7:43 to play. So welcome to the Smoky Mountain Conference Hobbton Wildcats as they try to run around the right side over there. They're going to spot it at the original line of scrimmage there. It's going to bring up a third down with 7:25 to play here. And now we expect Hobbton to try to air it out again as they passed once, ran once, and they have no yards to show for it. This is their first offensive series in this playoff game tonight, and they try the handoff to the left side. He pops outside, has a little running room, but great coverage over there by Josh Anthony. Great defensive coverage. They stayed in their lanes. They got the job done. So Anthony over there with a little help on the play from Travis Brooks, and now Hobbton is going to have to punt on their first offensive series, and this could be really big here in this football game. Our Maroon Devils scored rather impressively on the first drive, and Hobbton on their first drive got about 2 yards. So now fourth down and almost 8 to go. They're going to have to punt it back, as they'll punt it back now to the Maroon Devils. End over end punt, but it's got some distance. Going to be taken at the 42-yard line. Bringing it back over there is going to be Stephen Mercer. Mercer, good return, a penalty flag down. So that flag with 6:27 to play in the first quarter could be our first as we have a break in the action here. So the penalty flag was charged against our Maroon Devils, the first penalty flag of the night here. It's holding on the punt return. So now it's going to bring up a first down from about the 37-yard line instead of up near midfield. So let's see if the Devils can again put together a good offensive series. Nice hole on the right side again for Cody White as he cracks out across the 41 to the 42-yard line. Talking about you, Coach Rod White, his theory of how to beat the other team is we need to establish our will on them. Don't let them establish their will against our Maroon Devils. So right now the Devils have basically established our will over them in the words of Coach Rod White here tonight. Second down now. We need about 5, maybe 6 out of the I formation now. It's going to be Cody White again. He's getting a lot of work here early as he carries out to the 46-yard line. But what a career Cody White has had. He's had a great year this year. 144 carries coming in with 1,117 yards, averaging an unbelievable 7.8 yards a carry, 24 touchdowns this year. I was talking about 49. That's how many tackles he's had. So he's had 49 tackles on defense, 24 touchdowns on offense, and also 12 tackles for losses. Oh, we got a right tackle moving over there just a little bit as Ian McCauley, he's anxious and ready to roll here. So that's going to back us up 5 instead of 3rd down and 2. It's going to bring up a 3rd down and 7 now with 5:13 to play here in the first quarter. Bringing in the play from the sideline, it's going to be Jason Boston as he splits out wide to the left side now. 3rd down, we need 7. We got a man moving early. We're going to be offside again. So for the second consecutive time, we got a guy breaking out of the gate just a tad early. That's going to bring up now 3rd down and about 12 or so with 4:50 to play here in the first quarter. Another break in the action. So now the key for the Maroon Devils, keep the penalty flag in the officials' pockets. Now as McMahon sets up the screen on the left side, Cody White is there, and he's going to be hit, though, at the 40-yard line after a short gain. So for the first time tonight, our Maroon Devils will have to punt the football back to Hobbton. And right now on that drive, the worst enemy for the Devils, not the Hobbton Wildcats, but the yellow flag of the officials, as we had 2 consecutive illegal procedure penalties on the offense. So now 4th down. From the 40-yard line with 4:06 to play, and the Devils up 7-0 over the Hobbton Wildcats. Let's see what we can do with the punting game now. Smathers, nice punt's going to be taken at the 26-yard line, and good coverage by the punt unit. Great coverage, getting down the field in a hurry on the tackle for the Maroon Devils is going to be number 73, Mitchell Starr, to put a good lick on the Hobbton return man. 3:50 to go now at Swain County Memorial Stadium. 3:50 to play here in the first quarter. Hobbton second crack at the football now as they have a misdirection handoff to the left side. Nice run, another penalty flag down. Derek McDougal on the carry, 185-pound junior. He plays both ways. He's a tailback on one side, a linebacker on the other side. And we hope the officials don't do this all night. It's going to be offensive holding against Hobbton. Because when you have a game that's filled with penalties, it just really keeps the teams out of the rhythm. And let's see if that's going to be the case. We've seen probably as many penalties in the first quarter tonight as we've seen at halftime of most games this year. Of course, by halftime in most games this year, we're probably ahead by at least 35-0. So Hobbton trying to win their 3rd in a row over our Maroon Devils. As we mentioned earlier, they beat us 2 years ago in playoff activity. Then in 1993, they beat us for the 1A state championship. Hobbton Wildcats have a good tradition of their own. This time they run the handoff to the right side. It's going to be Ty Tichy again, and it's going to be great defense. Cody White, we were talking about Cody on defense, just as impressive as he is on offense. He has 12 tackles for losses this year, and that's going to be number 13 tackles for losses this year for Cody White as he comes knifing in to throw Hobbton for a loss here with 3:05 and counting left to play in the first quarter. Great, great crowd of Swain High Maroon Devil fans here tonight. Hobbton brought some fans, but these guys are over 350 miles away. We'll talk more about that as the game goes on. This time Hobbton wants to throw. Their southpaw quarterback throws it out to this side, and it's going to be in and out of the hands of the wide receiver. Pretty good coverage over there by the Maroon Devil defense. And Cody White, pass intended over there for John White, but he just couldn't hang on. The ball was there from the quarterback on the play, quarterback Ross Thornton, a junior. Thornton only plays one way. A lot of these guys play both ways on the Hobbton football team, as do our Maroon Devils here. 2:43 now on the clock to play in the first quarter. Third down and a long way to go now for Hobbton. One man in the backfield behind the quarterback, a man in motion now to the left side as the southpaw dumps it over there to the left side. It's going to be McDougal again, and he's stopped at the 16-yard line. Great, great coverage over there. It's going to be Josh Anthony on the stop along with Eric Stevenson. Good defense as, again, our guys stay in the lanes, get the job done with technique, and good, solid defense. Dropping back now is going to be Stephen Mercer to receive the punt. Also back there with him is going to be Josh Anthony, as the Maroon Devils could enjoy great field position here as Hobbton will be punting from inside their own 10-yard line. Not a bad punt at all. It's going to be taken at the 48-yard line. Bringing it back is going to be Josh Anthony, and he's knocked down at the 45-yard line of Hobbton with 2 minutes to play here in the first quarter at Swain County High School. The Maroon Devils back on offense with a 7-0 lead over Hobbton. McMahon handing off to Cody White, and that's been a big play all night. Cody White almost broke that one. He's finally brought down at the 30-yard line. But again, Cody White doing a great job carrying the football here tonight. Now, the winner of this game will go on to play either Elkin or Union. Elkin and Union are playing tonight. And both those teams, darn it, they knocked out Smoky Mountain Conference teams last Friday. Elkin beat Hayesville 30-6, Union beating Robbinsville 28-27, when Robbinsville missed on a point after touchdown that would have tied the game against Union and sent it into overtime. But Hayesville and Robbinsville shut down last week by Elkin and Union, respectively. The winner of this game will play the winner of that game in the state semifinals next Friday night. Toss to the left side. It's going to be Cody again. Good tackle this time by the Hobbton Wildcats. On the tackle, Ty Tichy over there, a junior. A lot of these guys are going to be back next year for Hobbton. Not a huge number of seniors on this Wildcat team. And again, they have a winning tradition, so Hobbton could be a real factor again next year in the state 1A playoffs. Just 1 minute to play now in the first quarter. Maroon Devils trying to punch another one in, leading 7-0 here. We haven't been held to this many points since the Murphy game just a few weeks ago. Toss to Cody White. Great blocking out in front, but he's going to be actually caught from behind. The guy that initially got the contact was Derek McDougal in the backfield, who slowed down Cody White just enough to allow help to come on the way at the 26-yard line. Now remember, if you have business and would like to advertise on this or any of the other great programming on Hometown Television, please call Tammy Mincy at 497-6435 or Cheryl Maxey at 488-1155. HTTV, quality local programming for Bryson City and the Maroon Devils. Scotty McMahon looks like he wanted to run the quarterback draw play, but Hobbton had other ideas as they knock us down for a loss on the play at about the 28-yard line. Good coverage coming in there from Hobbton from Anthony Royal, senior defensive end. Only weighs 167 pounds. And that's going to be the end of the first quarter. Our Devils lead 7-0 over the Hobbton Wildcats here at Swain County High School. Welcome back. As the Maroon Devils will try a field goal from Nick Zimmerman. This will be a 45-yard effort, and it's going to be a high snap. They get it down. Wow, this has plenty of distance, and it is good. 11:53 to play in the second quarter, And that's got to be a career long for Nick Zimmerman. A great field goal, and the Maroon Devils are on top 10-0 over the Hobbton Wildcats. Welcome back as Zimmerman, who has just booted a 44-yard field goal officially. We jump off sides. Our Maroon Devils are geared up, obviously. That is the third time we've been a little bit too anxious. We've had two illegal motion penalties and now an offside penalty. And I guess in the words of and thoughts maybe of Coach Rod White, penalties are not good, but if you're going to get a penalty, being overly aggressive is some you can sometimes look over. So we'll try to kick it again. Welcome back, fans, as Nick Zimmerman backs up five, and it still goes in the end zone. What a kick. What a kick. Nick Zimmerman, who just booted a 44-yard field goal, one shy of his career record of 45. He backs up five and still kicks it in the end zone. This guy can hammer the football. So now Hobbton will take over first and 10 at the 20-yard line. Talking about Elkin, Elkin and Union tied at 7-7 in their quarterfinal playoff game. And, of course, if the Maroon Devils win tonight over Hobbton, we would like nothing better than to play Elkin, the team that knocked us out of a possible State 1A championship title last year. And this time, if we win tonight, Elkin would come up to this neck of the woods. Hand off to the left side now as carrying the football is going to be Derek McDougal. Gain of a couple on the left side, 11:46 to play. But talking about Hobbton, they did come a long way up the road. According to Yahoo Maps driving directions, it's 356 miles and takes 7 hours from Bryson City to Newton Grove, if you believe Yahoo Maps driving directions. But any way you cut it, they had to come a long way. They're from Newton Grove, which is about halfway between Fayetteville and Goldsboro. So Hobbton, long trip up to Swain County High School tonight. Hand off to the right side. It's going to be Ty Tichy, and Tichy, not much at the 25-yard line. That's going to bring up a third down and five now for the Hobbton Wildcats. Hobbton coming in, averaging 29 points per game, but they give up 23 points a game. On the other side of that coin, our Maroon Devils averaging 45.5 points a game, but giving up only 8.8 points a game. So give the nod to the Maroon Devils on defense especially, not giving up many points. So far on the state playoffs, we haven't given up any points. Third down and five, left side. Here comes Hobbton. Here comes another defensive stand. What a great stop over there by Dusty Lossie, who is a big man on both sides of the line for this Maroon Devil football team. Now Hopton's going to have to punt it back to Swain County with 10:25 to play in the second quarter. And the Devils on top, 10-0. Thank goodness to a 44-yard field goal by Nick Zimmerman. And then almost as impressive, he kicked it in the end zone after a 5-yard high snap. Look out, this could be dangerous. Devils are coming, and now we're going to have a penalty flag for roughing the punter. When we thought we might have had a big break, Justin Evans runs into the punter, and the Maroon Devil fans are booing big time. But no question, this one might come back. Let's see as the officials are talking it over. But the official was standing right there, and he threw the flag as soon as Justin Evans barreled in. Well, fans, twist here in the second quarter tonight. Instead of getting the ball back on a punt, Hobbton has it first down and 10 after we run into the punter. So from the 36, first and 10, they toss to the right side. Wow, their running back is just surrounded by Devils. Cody White is there. Also there is Craig Autry. How many other guys are there? I mean, a bunch of guys. Josh Anthony on the play. Also Neil Cochran. I mean, you name it. Our guys never gave Hobbton a chance to breathe on that play. Second down, still almost 10 to go. One thing about Hobbton here in the first half, not a lot of offensive creativity, as our Maroon Devils have pretty well figured out what they're doing offensively tonight. But as we've said all season long, the Swain defense has really set the tone for this football team. Our offense is very solid, but the defense really sets the tone. Pass down the left side, just off the fingertips of Juwan Faison, and it's going to be intercepted by Josh Anthony. Josh Anthony has 6 interceptions this year. That is the 7th interception for Anthony this season. There's a real hawk on defense. 7 interceptions for Anthony this year. And we were just talking about the lack of creativity, and that one blew up on Hobbton with 9:10 left to play in the second quarter now. And the Devils get the football back here. Let's see if we can get some of that offensive firepower going here. Again, more so than Hobbton, the yellow penalty flags in the official's pocket has been the enemy of our Swain County offense tonight. Hand off right side. We get about three from Cody White out to the 46-yard line. But talking about Hobbton again, they're from Sampson County down at Newton Grove, North Carolina. Sampson County is actually home to four high schools, Hobbton, Lakewood, Midway, and Union, all 1A high schools, so four 1A high schools in one county down there. And as you remember, Newton Grove is near Spivey's Corner and about halfway between Fayetteville and Goldsboro, a long way from the mountains of Swain County. Second down now, head off to the left side. It's going to be Stevenson breaking a couple of tackles, and here comes another penalty flag, and this is probably an offensive holding call as Stevenson needed only a couple of yards, and there is offensive holding again. So right now, the Maroon Devils getting the job done, but penalty flags just keep stopping us here, especially on offense. 8:27 to play. We lead 10-0. Having a great year, 51 tackles this year, number three on the team on defense. He brings the play in. Second down. Back to throw is going to be Scotty McMahon. Only one interception this year, doing a great job. He throws down the right sideline, and so it's going to be out of bounds, and so we'll try again. A lot of contact on that particular pass over there in front of the Hobbton Wildcat football team. But the Maroon Devils in front, 10-0. Coming in now with the play is going to be Jason Boston, who has had a great year. His senior season as well. A real stalwart on defense, 48 tackles for Boston. Third down now. We still need roughly 18. 8 minutes to play in the half. Scotty throwing back to the left side. He's got a man. Cody White is there, and he was hit. Great hit by the defense. And it's going to be complete at the 45-yard line. What a great job by Cody White to hang on to that football. Cody was really hammered by DJ Jackson, the quarterback over there. He hit him just as the ball arrived, but great focus and concentration by Cody White. And that is... Maybe one of the most critical first downs of this first half with 7:51 to play. But again, great hit by Jackson. But Cody White amazingly held onto the football because they both arrived at the same time. And Jackson's got to be shaking his head wondering, what have I got to do to get this guy's attention? First down and 10. Scotty back to throw again. Straight drop, throws back to the screen on the left side. Just off the fingertips of Justin Evans, incomplete. Had some good blocking out in front there. Leading the way was Mitchell Green, and Dusty Lossie passed just a hair high this year. But talking about some of the teams in the playoffs, Elkin, of course, still alive. Elkin has won two straight 1A titles. If Elkin wins tonight and we win tonight, we would meet next Friday in the state 1A semifinal game for the right to go on to Raleigh, North Carolina, December 11th. At high noon for the state 1A championship. But still, there's Hobbton in the way. Second down. This time, it's going to be Casey Shuler, his first carry tonight. He gets five down to the 40-yard line. Shuler, another great season this year, 352 yards and 10 touchdowns, averaging 8.4 yards a carry this year for the Devils. Some updated scores here in the third round of the state playoffs. Second quarter scores in 3A. Robertson, Oliver Ashbrook, 21-7. Asheville and Burns tied at 7-7. And in the 2A, Shelby leads Pisgah by a score of 6-0. So a lot of exciting action. And our Western North Carolina teams right now not having a bad Friday night. Thanks to our ace Asheville Citizen reporter, Jeff Bryson, on the scene here tonight at Swain County Memorial Stadium. Cody White, very close to a first down at the 35-yard line. Let's see where they spot it. The way they spot it, it looks a little shy, just a little short. So that's going to bring up fourth down and probably a foot or less. Fourth down and very short now. 6:24 to play. Great first half. Maroon Devils up 10-0. And might be a little more if not for the penalties here. Again, they have been a problem. Almost like that yellow on the helmets of Hobbton. It looks like Michigan out there. Hand off to Cody White. He has the first down. He's in the secondary. Down inside the 20-yard line is going to be Cody White. And that's why Cody White is averaging almost 8 yards a carry running the football. As the Maroon Devils move the chains, a new set of downs just inside the 20-yard line. We're talking about the playoffs tonight. From the final state Associated Press rankings in the 1A poll, 6 out of the final top 10 are still in the playoffs. 4 are gone. So some validity to that state AP poll. Albemarle, Maiden, Swain, and Southside were the top 4. They're all still in the playoffs. So those are the strongest 4 teams in the state, we think. And now we have a timeout with the Maroon Devils up 10-0 with 5:38 to play in the second quarter. Welcome back, fans, after the Maroon Devil timeout. 5:38 to go in the first half. 10-0. Maroon Devils in the lead. Hobbton showing blitz. They come from the left side. And nice run by Casey Shuler. He ran right by it. Casey down to the 15-yard line. Talking about the Hobbton defense, not a real big defense. They have a couple of guys over on the left side of the defensive line. Maurice Robinson, who is 290 pounds, and Wayne Strickland, who weighs 230. Other than that, these two guys are the only real size on this defense of Hobbton. Pretty small everywhere else on defense. And up to the left side again. Cody White down to the 10. Look out from the 5 all the way to the 2-yard line. Cody White caught from behind where he was going in. DJ Jackson. Jackson caught him from behind. And as we mentioned, that's the advantage Hobbton has is speed. But right now, the Maroon Devils' execution on offense and defense is the reason the Maroon Devils are up 10-0 with just under 5 minutes to play now. Coming in with a play, Scotty McMahon, the quarterback, goes to the sideline quickly. Does a good job. Offensive coordinator Steve Manley really has a lot of creativity and thought in the offensive play calling. First down and goal. And wait a minute. Here comes another darn yellow flag. Again, this has been the Achilles heel in the first half, and I'm sure our coaches are going to be chatting with the guys at halftime about that. So now, instead of first down and goal at the 3, it's going to come back out to about the 7, almost 8-yard line. So first down and goal again. They're going to spot it at the 7. Still plenty of time, 4.5 minutes to play in the first half here. Seniors kind of on a mission here. These seniors lost to Hobbton 2 years ago as sophomores, so they remember very well. Breaking the action, another Swain timeout with the Devils up 10-0. And here we go, fans, with a first down. New set of downs and goal to go, getting a lot of that penalty yardage back. Cody White cracks the left side of the line. Good blocking up front there as leading the way is going to be Dusty Lossie. And he's a pretty big guy himself at 6'4", 295. This time coming in with a play is going to be Josh Anthony, who has our only touchdown of the night, a great pass reception from Scotty McMahon. The only other score, a 44-yard field goal by Nick Zimmerman, only 1 yard shy of his all-time 45-yard field goal record. This time, it's going to be the wishbone toss left side. Plenty of blocking, but good work by Hobbton on defense as they knock down Eric Stevenson at the 1 yard line. So this should bring up a third and goal at the 1 yard line. 3:25 on the clock, and the Devils up 10-0 over the Hobbton Wildcats. We'll line up in the power backfield. Only one man wide right. Right side, Cody White is in. It looks good. Touchdown, Maroon Devils. Cody White bangs it in. Just a good power surge by the offensive line and blocking by his running mates in the backfield. And Cody White makes it a 16-0 Swain High lead with 2:56 to play. before that run, Cody White had 12 carries for 89 yards. Now he's got 13 for about 90 yards here in the first half. Great first half for Cody White as Zimmerman will line up for the point after touchdown. And this one is good. So 2:56 to go in the half, and it's Swain 17, Hobbton 0. Nick Zimmerman boots it again for the Maroon Devils. This one low, line drive picked up at the 4-yard line. On the return, the Hobbton Wildcats, little stutter step, and out across the 17-yard line. But the Devils, good coverage again. Our special teams doing a great job here with 2:48 to go in the first half.
Cody's almost past break.
2:48 to go here in the first half. The penalty finally going against Hobbton. They got a penalty here, and now we get offside again. Dusty Lossie, his motor is running here tonight. He's been in on a lot of good plays tonight for Swain County's defense. That one, wow, Hobbton moved, so Dusty was drawn offside, so it makes Dusty feel better as it's going to put the ball back at the 4-yard line of Hobbton now with 2:46 to play in the first half. So the officials have been all over the game. We've seen a lot of penalty flags here in the first half, more than we've seen in some time now. So now the Maroon Devils on defense, where we have really been stellar this year, pitching a shutout tonight against the Hobbton Wildcats, who run the ball just across the 6-yard line. Leading the charge on defense over there was looks like Mitchell Green. Nothing new there. Mitchell Green leading the team in tackles this year with 56 tackles. He is one of the captains tonight, along with Van Downs and Cody White. Those were your three captains leading these Devils onto the field. 2:15 and counting now. Second down, a loss of 3, as the Wildcats need 13. Got a man in motion now. They turn and a little misdirection handoff, but it didn't fool anybody as Derek McDougal carries there for Hobbton out to near the 7-yard line. Again, Mitchell Green. Nothing new there. Mitchell Green on the stop along with Travis Brooks. Third down and 10 now. Devils would like, of course, to shut down Hobbton on one more play, forcing a punt and allowing the Maroon Devils to probably go into the locker room with a 17-0 lead here. Again, our defense has bent a little bit tonight, but really hasn't broken at all. Little flip out to the left side, and the swing pass does not happen. Derek McDougal can't pick it off the top of the turf here tonight. So now Hobbton will be forced to punt. A junior. Let's see if we come after him here. Pretty good rush, but not a big rush. No penalty flag this time. It's going to be taken by Anthony on the run at the 35, 25, 20, down the sideline, all the way into the end zone. Bringing it all the way back is going to be Josh Anthony. Josh Anthony, who has already caught a touchdown pass tonight from Scotty McMahon, now brings it back on the punt return. That one coming from out about 37 yards on the punt return for a touchdown. We thought it would be 17-0 at halftime. We still have a minute 18 to play, and the Maroon Devils have struck again, leading 23-0 over the Hobbton Wildcats. Now as Zimmerman will line up for another point after touchdown. He has 113 in his career. He'll try to make it 114 with this one. And now the Maroon Devils are short a guy. Coming in is going to be Craig Autry. So can't have a point after touchdown without the long snapper. So the Autry coming in for the point after. Good snap, good hold, and Zimmerman with plenty of room, and the point is good. So now with 1:18 to go in the half, Devils all over Hobbton, 24-0. And away we go. Nick Zimmerman this time booting from the 40-line drive, hitting him right in the chest at the 5-yard line. It's going to be facing on the return, and he is running into traffic up near the 20-yard line. Looks like Casey Schuler, who likes to hit people anyway. Also in on the stop is going to be Jason Boston, who also plays good defense. 1:10 to go. Maroon Devils will be on defense here, and that, again, is where this team has really set the tone tonight on defense. We have scored 24 points on offense, but again, a big goose egg on the Hobbton scoreboard. And this team, as Coach Rod White likes to say, we have established our will over Hobbton. here in the first half tonight. This time, three wide receivers. First time we've seen this tonight for Hobbton. And we get offside a little bit again. Just a little anxious over there. Good Maroon Devil crowd on hand here. Coming up Friday, if we win tonight, it looks like we will the way it's going now. Maroon Devils will play at home for the final time this year. So you don't like to look too far ahead, but if we hang on to win, our Maroon Devils will play at home this Friday again. And hopefully a date at Carter-Finley Stadium, December 11 on Saturday at 12 noon. December 11 at 12 noon. Hopefully we can circle that date on the calendar. Another penalty flag down. We've had one penalty already on this drive. So let's see what this penalty is all about now with 1:03 to go. 1 minute to go in the first half here as Hobbton backs up five. Illegal procedure on offense. They toss to the right side. They run to the right side. Ty Tichy, and he is hit at the 20-yard line. Cody White slowed him down. And coming up to finish him off is going to be Justin Evans. So a good combination, number four and number five, Evans and White. Put the hurt. McDougal having a long night tonight. He's one of the tailbacks here on this Hobbton Wildcat football team. And he's probably wondering, wow, this is not a whole lot of fun coming up here on a cold Friday night in the mountains, almost 400 miles from home, and we're taking a beating 24-0 here with a final 15 seconds in the first half. Winding down, hand off, big hole on the left side, their best running play of the night. So a nice run by Will Strickland, the fullback, but I'm afraid the clock is going to be the worst enemy for Hobbton as the officials move the chains. That'll stop the clock momentarily. They spot it at the 35. Now the clock will run again. Hobbton maybe running their final play of the first half, and they're going to have to hurry to get this one off. Now down to two, down to one. They're not going to get it off. Yes, they do, just barely. Back to throw, down the left side. It's up for grabs, and it's going to be picked up again. Picking out the pass is going to be number 34, Jason Boston. Boston down the right sideline, still going at the 25. He spun around. He's still going to the 15. Finally knocked out of bounds, and that's the final play of the first half. But what a way to end at half, as the Maroon Devils lead 24-0, and another pickoff for Jason Boston. Fans, a great second half coming up here on Hometown Television, HTTV. Half is gone, the second half on the way. The Maroon Devils in control right now, 24-0, as Hobbton is going to get the football back, and I think the officials just realized the teams are on the wrong side of the field. So let's switch sides of the field, and we'll kick it off when they all get set here. Now we're ready to go on the right side of the field. Nick Zimmerman, he kicked us in the end zone anyway, so it doesn't matter to him whether it's going to the left or going to the right. He just boots it deep, and the other guys start off at the 20-yard line. That's a very familiar story to Swain High Maroon Devil football this year. But again, a dominant defense in the first half, giving the Maroon Devils a 24-0 lead here in the state quarterfinals. And it's hard to believe this is such a dominant Maroon Devil performance in a game this deep into the playoffs. Next week, it's the semifinals. 2 weeks, the state 1A championship. Again, in the 1A division, it's going to be at Carter-Finley Stadium, home of the North Carolina State Wolfpack in Raleigh, North Carolina. December 11 at 12 noon, if everything gels together for the Maroon Devils. 44, giving the Maroon Devils a first down. Just shy of the 30-yard line with 7:08 to play. They're going to spot it at the 29-yard line. Next on the list in the rushing department is going to be Robbie Brown. So Cody White continues to move on up the list. Robbie Brown, just ahead of Brown is Johnny Buck Mitchell. Rocky Dietz, the all-time rushing leader for the Maroon Devils. And the Devils stay on the ground across the 35-yard line.
All down by number 88 for the Wildcats, Wayne Strickland.
Scotty McMahon carrying some tonight. That's one thing that's deceiving about Scotty McMahon. He throws the ball so well, but he also runs it well. Scotty on the season doing a good job throwing and running. He has rushed for over 376 yards and 8 touchdowns coming into this ball game, passing for over 1,000 yards. So a double barrel threat at quarterback for the Maroon Devils and Scotty McMahon. Casey Shuler gets the toss. He crosses a 35 out to the 37-yard line. A great run for Casey Shuler, another guy who's had a very solid season. Shuler coming in averaging 8.4 yards a carry, 10 touchdowns, 352 yards on the ground for Casey Shuler. Casey only a junior. He'll be back as one of the leaders of this Maroon Devil football team next season. Fast-moving third quarter, only 6 minutes to play, as Hobbton had a very impressive drive to open the third quarter, scoring for the only time here tonight. Handoff left side, Cody White gets the Maroon Devils a first down across the 40-yard line.
First and 10, Maroon.
Talking about some of the state championships, Albemarle. We were talking about them just a moment ago. Albemarle has won three straight 1AA titles, and they've won 39 straight games and 49 and 50 dating back to 2001. Thank goodness they're in the 1AA level. Right now, Cody White, 109 yards on the night, as he has just had a great night, and we still have a lot of football left to play. As we mentioned, Cody moved just ahead of Brett Connolly, and we have a timeout now with the Devils up 24-7.
Hare & Associates is a full-service civil engineering, land surveying, and land planning company located in Bryson City. Hare & Associates was founded by James Thurlow Heron and has been in the business since 1959. Hare & Associates knows that your land and your home are your largest investments that you will make, and we are dedicated to protecting your investments. Heron & Associates is a proud supporter of Maroon Devil football on hometown television.
We would like to welcome you to Bryson City Pharmacy, conveniently located at Valley Village Shopping Center, Bryson City. Need a prescription filled fast? Our phone number is 488-1705. Pull up to our drive-through window and we'll have it waiting for you. That's Bryson City Pharmacy, your hometown choice, supporting our hometown team.
So now the Maroon Devils are looking at first down and 10 at the 11-yard line. And this time, kind of a tough handoff, but Casey Shuler takes it. Kind of looked like Scotty McMahon and Casey Shuler were like, let's see, you take it. No, I'll take it. No, you got it. No, I got it. And finally, they still get the job done down to the 3-yard line. So Casey Shuler, just a powerful back at 5'11", 236 pounds. But again, what a night by Cody White, as he is just well over 100 yards here tonight. So now, Scotty lines him up, hands off to Casey again. Casey is in the end zone. The Devils get on the board again with 2:26 to play in the third quarter, and the Maroon Devils lead impressively 30-7 over the Hobbton Wildcats. And the Devils starting to feel a little better about moving on to Friday's game, which would be the last one this year at Swain County Memorial Stadium. If we continue and win tonight, one more game at home. Now for the point after by Nick Zimmerman. Good snap, good hold, and the point is up, and it's good as well. 31-7, Swain leading Hopton with 2:26 to go in the third.
We would like to welcome you to Bryson City Pharmacy, conveniently located at Valley Village Shopping Center, Bryson City. Need a prescription filled fast? Our phone number is 488-1705. Pull up to our drive-through window and we'll have it waiting for you. That's Bryson City Pharmacy, your hometown choice, supporting our hometown team.
Hare & Associates is a full-service civil engineering, land surveying, and land planning company located in Bryson City. Hare & Associates was founded by James Thurlow Heron and has been in the business since 1959. Hare & Associates knows that your land and your home are your largest investments that you will make, and we are dedicated to protecting your investments. Hare & Associates is a proud supporter of Maroon Devil football on hometown television.
Danny Council.
Yes, sir. What's yours?
And away we go as Nick Zimmerman, who's had another great night, kicks this one low, and it's going to go into the end zone anyway. It's so hot, it's like a line drive in baseball. The center fielder just couldn't handle it. As Juwan Faison, who's had a long night, he's been injured a couple of times, watch it go into the end zone, and they'll take over at the 20-yard line.
13 start the fourth.
Okay.
Hobbton and Warren.
17.
First and 10, Wildcats.
Hobbton now
from the 20.
With 2:26 to play in the third quarter. And before they even snap the ball, we have a penalty flag. They must have taken too much time.
Delay of
game is going to be charged against Hobbton. That'll move it back five. One updated score. Of course, by the time you watch this game, you'll know who we get to play if we win here tonight. But a real barn burner going on between Elkin and Union. Elkin leading Union 17-13. Elkin has won two straight 1A championships. And nobody would love to end that more than the Swain County Maroon Devils. Hand off to C.J. Oates. First carry of his first carry of the game for Oates tonight of Hobbton. But again, talking about Elkin. As you know, they barely beat us last year at Elkin. They have never played here at Swain County High School, but Elkin has two straight 1A titles in their pocket. And if they win tonight, they would come to Swain County Memorial Stadium Friday night if our Maroon Devils win tonight, 31-7. Devils leading here tonight over Hobbton, just under 2 minutes to play. So that's another revenge game, if you will. It could be coming up next for the Maroon Devils as the handoff goes to the right side. And, oh, he's stopped for no gain on the play. Carrying the football was Danny Council, and he's going to need some counsel on how to run the football after that hit. Coming up, we had Dusty Lossie and Earl King. Good to see Earl King in there. He's had a tough year with injuries and so forth. But Earl back in that defense for the Maroon Devils. Third down now, Hobbton. Still trying to figure out the Maroon Devil defense, but not too many people have done that all season long. As Coach Rod White, who is really into the defensive side of the football, fielding another solid defensive unit this year. Handoff goes to the left side, a little reverse. It's going to be Tichy again, who had a 50-yard run earlier that led to Hobbton's only touchdown, is knocked down at the 25-yard line. On the tackle is going to be Craig Autry and company as good defense in there for the Devils. Cody White also assisting now. It's fourth down, though. Wildcats have to punt it away with under a minute to play here on the third quarter. And the Devils in control, 31-7.
Fourth and six.
On the punt now, it's going to be Dustin Bryan. We've returned one tonight. Josh Anthony is going to be the deep man. It's going to be fielded by the up man at the 48-yard line. On the return, it's going to be Stephen Mercer. Mercer down the right side, only one man to beat. He beats him. Now it's going to be a foot race. He's trying to get to the corner, just doesn't make it. All the way down to the 7-yard line is going to be Stephen Mercer. So again, special teams have come up big tonight for the Maroon Devils.
47?
They got some publicity this week in the Asheville Citizen. Great article in the paper this week about Maroon Devil football. Upended, good hit over there by Hobbton as Eric Stevenson carries to just inside the 5-yard line. And we might have an injured player. Getting up slowly on the play was Josh Anthony. And he's a little gimpy on an ankle as the third quarter comes to an end. And the Devils are right now opening a big can over Hobbton, 31-7.
We would like to welcome you to Bryson City Pharmacy, conveniently located at Valley Village Shopping Center, Bryson City. Need a prescription filled fast? Our phone number is 488-1705. Pull up to our drive-through window and we'll have it waiting for you. That's Bryson City Pharmacy, your hometown choice, supporting our hometown team.
Hare & Associates is a full-service civil engineering, land surveying, and land planning company located in Bryson City. Hare & Associates was founded by James Thurlow Heron and has been in the business since 1959. Hare & Associates knows that your land and your home are your largest investments that you will make, and we are dedicated to protecting your investments. Heron & Associates is a proud supporter of Maroon Devil football on hometown television.
Underway as the Devils toss to the left side. Stevenson, nice hole. A penalty flag comes in as he is very close to the goal line. But hold the phone on the yellow flag here as the Devils attempt to put some more points on the board here tonight over the Hobbton Wildcats. Just underway fourth quarter. Holding against the Devils is the call. That's going to back us up some as we had it inside. Well inside the 5-yard line. So now the ball comes all the way back to the 15-yard line. So a holding call. As we mentioned, as far as trying to stop the Devils, the officials and the yellow penalty flag have stopped us more than the Hobbton defense, actually. So we've lost more yards from penalties than we have from the Hobbton defense. The Wildcat defense just has not stopped us much tonight, especially as far as losing yards as much as the penalties have. But I'm sure the coaches will talk about that as the Maroon Devils are running out of time. Got to get the playoff in a hurry. Scotty does. Tosses to the right side at the 15. Down to the 10-yard line. It's going to be, looks like, Stevenson on the carry. Eric Stevenson down near the 10.
Making the stop for the Wildcats at the time, number 62.
Scotty McMahon looking to the sideline.
Stevenson picks up five.
And the play from offensive coordinator Steve Manley.
Third and goal from the 10-yard line.
Big third down here coming up for the Maroon Devils. Coming in is going to be Jason Boston. Talking about dominating defense, Hobbton, 104 total yards, 90 rushing, 24 passing in the ballgame tonight. So that's what you call defense. Pass in the end zone is going to be intercepted. Pass intercepted by, looks like, Faison on the return down the sideline. He's going to be caught over there as Cody White drags him down over near the 25-yard line. Pass intended for Justin Evans, but again, Faison just basically stepped in front of the pass and brought it all the way back. So the best defensive play of the night here for the Hobbton Wildcats in the fourth quarter with 10:36 to go here.
Second of the season.
Hanging on to a little bit of light at the end of the tunnel, but I'm afraid it's a Maroon Devil freight train throwing down the left side. He's got a man. His big tight end was there, but he overthrew him. And he is a big target. Tight end is their biggest offensive lineman at 230 pounds. But ball just a little overthrown. Talking about Scotty McMahon, that is only the second interception he has given up all season long, which is incredible considering that he has thrown for over 1,000 yards this year. 144 passes over 1,000 yards. No, check that. I'm looking at Cody White's stats. Scotty McMahon, 70 out of 116 for still over 1,000 yards. So over 70 passes, only two interceptions. Incredible year. Down the right sideline. Pass just overthrown now as Hobbton is pulling out all the stops. Pass intended for Faison. So now it's almost like they're just trying to outrun us down the sideline and throw it up. Hopefully somebody will run under it. 10:24. It's, I guess you'd call it, desperation with the Maroon Devils up 31-7. Early in the fourth quarter here tonight. And as we've been saying throughout the broadcast, if the Devils hang on to win one more game here at Swain County Memorial Stadium and Boyce Dietz Field, and Elkin led Union at last check 17-13. That would set up a great rematch of last season's State 1A semifinals. But this year, it's going to be at Swain County Memorial Stadium. Handoff left side. Cody White is there and drags him down at the 33-yard line. Cody White has played as well defensively tonight as he has offensively. And that's a pretty good night considering he has rushed for over 100 yards, but he has been in on a bunch of tackles. Cody White is going to be one tired Devil. And there's timeout with 10 minutes to play. The Devils up 31-7. Running it back with 10 minutes to play, down by 24 points. High punt, not real deep. It's going to be taken at the 42-yard line. Nice fair catch over there by Josh Anthony, and we'll get it right there. First and 10, Maroon Devils. Now the Maroon Devils, you kind of have a feeling we're going to run the football time after time after time. Cody White, here he goes again. Cody with 8 yards out to the 50-yard line. We're going to try to run the ball. We're going to try to keep it in bounds, and the clock is just going to kill Hobbton just as our Maroon Devils have done tonight as we lead 31-7. Coming into the ball game tonight, Coach Rod White, 69-31-1 in his 8 years as head coach here at Swain County High School in the playoffs. What a record. In 8 years, he has been to well over 100 playoff games. Second down, we need a couple. Casey Shuler gets that down to the 45-yard line, so the running game kind of clockwork. And I will say this, our running game has a little more imagination than Hobbton's has tonight. But again, talking more about Coach Rod White, just a great tenure here. His teams are 18-5 over six seasons, including last week's win. So 69-31-1 overall in his 8 years at Swain County High School in the playoffs. And what a great, great record. Talking about that, we'll check that again in a minute. First down now as here comes Cody White again, and he's still going, and he has another first down to the 32-yard line. Cody White, just his kind of night. And nobody wants to play Elkin more than Cody White does. Nice article again in the Asheville Citizens this week about Cody White, and he felt so bad about fumbling the football against Elkin last year. But Cody, you've got to understand too, my friend, that you win as a team, you lose as a team, and one play is not going to set the whole stage. First down and 10 now. The Devils stay in the I formation. Scotty runs the option. He's going to run it this time himself, and he's got some room. 20, 15, 10. Scotty McMahon's best run tonight, all the way down to the 9-yard line of Hobbton with 8 minutes, 11 seconds to play, and the Devils in control here, 31-7.
Maroon Devils. A 23-yard
gain
by quarterback Scotty
Knight. Maroon Devils run in the playoffs is really historical around the state of North Carolina, as we have won more playoff games than anybody else in the state since 1975, as the Maroon Devils after tonight will have 66 playoff wins, and nobody can match that, as we have a fumbled football at the 10-yard line. Scotty McMahon down near the 10. It's going to be Hopton's ball. So a lot of guys are on the football, but Hopton gets it back, keeping us out of the end zone with 7:44 to play here on the fourth quarter. So now the Hopton Wildcats just hanging on to a thread here of any hopes at all of moving down the road in the playoffs. They fumble the ball back, and now the Maroon Devils have it. How about that on one play? Hobbton fumbles it. It's recovered inside the 20-yard line, and it's going to be recovered by, looks like, Justin Evans. So Justin Evans coming up with a football. In two plays, we had two fumbles, and now the Devils have it back. But again, to talk more about the Maroon Devils playoff run, we're still leading the state in overall playoffs wins since 1975 with 66 after tonight. The Maroon Devils are 66-19 during that span with six state championships. So what a run since 75. 7.5 minutes to play here. The Devils might tack some more points on before this one is over, as we got the football back on the fumble recovery by Justin Evans. Now Scotty McMahon is going to be stopped on the play. Big tackle over there by a big guy, Maurice Robinson, who weighs 290 pounds, and you can see him from the press box. This guy's hard to miss. So now that's going to bring up a second down and 10 now, as coming in with a play from the sideline is going to be Jason Boston. But a great playoff run here, as the Maroon Devils just keep on winning. And again, Rod White doing a great job. He will be 19-5 in the playoffs over 6 years. Now Cody White's going to run into a wall again. This time on the tackle is going to be Wayne Strickland, the other big guy on their defense at 230 pounds. Overall, not a big team physically, this Hobbton Wildcat team. A couple of big guys on defense, as we mentioned, Maurice Robinson at 290 pounds, Strickland at 230. On offense, only one guy on the offensive line has any size at all, and that's their tight end, which is Strickland at 230 pounds. Their average weight from tackle to tackle on the offensive line of Hobbton, only 179 pounds. So not the biggest team physically. As we have dominated the line of scrimmage here tonight, as now the Maroon Devils have called a timeout with 6:09 to play, and the Devils up 31-7. Welcome back, everybody, after the Maroon Devil timeout. An update in the other game in the state 1A quarterfinals. Union now leading Elkin 19-17 with about 5:40 to play. Another penalty flag down, as we're going to try a wide receiver pass in the end zone. It's actually almost caught. Getting his hands on it momentarily was Steven Mercer on the pass over there from Josh Anthony, throwing it in double coverage and still almost completing it, but a penalty flag down. So Union and Elkin really going at it. We got a penalty flag against the Maroon Devils on the play with 6:02 to play. So Union and Elkin going right down to the wire, and that's something we really haven't done this year, is go down to the wire in a football game. So we might find out maybe next week. We'll see how the Maroon Devils respond, because we just haven't really been taken into a football game really into the fourth quarter. So now the Maroon Devils are going to try a field goal. Nick Zimmerman has one tonight at 44 yards. They're going to spot this football at about the 27, making this a 37-yard effort, basically in the middle of the field here. So a good angle for Zimmerman. Holding is going to be 82, Josh Anthony. High snap, he gets it down. He has the distance. Oh, it's not going to be good. So just under six to go, and the Devils still in control, though, 31-7. It's your DVDs, only $15. Great Christmas presents. They're on sale at the concession stand right there on the table near the concession stand. They try to run it around the right side, and they got a few yards out near the 25-yard line. Hometown Television, HTTV, Bryson City. 5.5 minutes to go here. The Devils looking to move on. Friday night, is it going to be Union? Is it going to be Elkin? We know what the Maroon Devil fans would prefer. But right now, as we broadcast this game, of course, on Friday night here at the press box, Union leads 19-17 with about 5 minutes to play in that other state quarterfinal ball game. But a great night tonight, again, for the defense. When you make it to the state quarterfinals and only allow 7 points, that's saying a lot for your defense. Cody White on another stop. What else is new on defense? As the chains move for Hobbton, but I think they have to be resigned to the fact that their football season is going to be ending right here at Swain County Memorial Stadium. They beat us the only two times we have played. A couple of years ago in the state playoffs, and back in 1993, actually, for the state 1A championship. But Hobbton coming to Swain County, a different story. They hand off this time to Oates. Oates trying to do the jitterbug, and he's knocked down for no gain at the 31-yard line. In there, it's going to be 39 among others. Eric Stevenson on the tackle. 4:40 and counting here. As the Maroon Devils can feel the celebration, it's just not official yet. But we hope all the Maroon Devil fans will be coming out this Friday night when we play in the state semifinals for the right to play for the state 1A championship, which will be December 11 on Saturday at 12 noon at Carter-Finley Stadium, home of the North Carolina State Wolfpack. Back to throw, Thornton. Oh, he's got his man, and he can't hang on. Again, good defense as he had the pass down there for Faison, but it's going to be knocked down again. Good defense by Stephen Mercer down there. Also with him back there playing deep center field is going to be Josh Anthony. What a great night for Anthony. He has returned a punt for a touchdown. He has got a pass from Scotty McMahon for a touchdown. So I guess if you picked an MVP on offense, Josh Anthony is having a great night tonight, along with Cody White, who has run the football just superbly against this Hobbton Wildcat defense. 31-7. Another Devil domination, if you will, as Thornton is trying to run for it, and he got about three, and that's going to be it at the 37-yard line.
Number 61 and 62 on the Devil.
So now, as the Devil fans continue to urge on the team here, a lot of good vibrations, if you will, going on at Swain County Memorial Stadium and Boyce Deitch Field with 3:45 to play. And now the Wildcats are going to be going for it, obviously, on 4th and 5. To try to wind up their football season here. So their first trip to Swain County Memorial Stadium, not a fun one, as they have a long ride back home down to Newton Grove, halfway between Fayetteville and Goldsboro. Pass complete over the middle. Nice pass to the 46-yard line of Swain County. Pass complete to 32 down there, John White. So White on the receiving end of that pass from Ross Thornton. So White receives, as now Hobbton will move the chains. One thing about Hobbton, a lot of juniors on this football team, a team that could very well be around in the playoffs again next year. So a lot of guys coming back for the Wildcats next season. 3:19 now, clock running down. The Wildcats get another set of downs here, but it's kind of all for naught, if you will. Or as they say, it's academic. With the Devils in front, 31-7 here. 3:05 and still counting. Got a man in motion to the right side, running toward the Hobbton bench. Looking over there, it's going to be Thornton, and he's going to be sacked on the play. 39, Stevenson in on the sack for the Maroon Devils. Also, Dusty Lossie coming in there. And also in on the sack is going to be 62, Earl King. So the tri-sack, if you will, on Thornton, the quarterback. We talked about in the pregame show with Toby Burrell about the speed of Hobbton. Well, the speed has been nullified, my friends, as the Devils stop the speed. Tichy broke loose on a 50-yard run, which is probably a third of their total offense here tonight. Other than that one big play, Hobbton has not put a lot of impressive numbers on the board on offense. Now they hand off to a back who hasn't carried much tonight, Anthony Royale, a senior on the carry. So I guess they're getting some seniors some playing time, playing in their last game ever as a Hobbton Wildcat tonight. Just over 2 minutes and counting now, the clock running. And the Devils celebration about to begin as we'll look ahead to Friday night. Is it going to be Union? Is it going to be Elkin? That is the only question left to be decided here in this west bracket of the State 1A playoffs. And we have an official in the middle of the field blowing a whistle. Now they move out of the way. Now we can get it rolling here. One thing about it, we haven't had a lot of luxury to play as many guys tonight as we've seen the last couple of weeks in the state playoffs. And here comes the quarterback. He's going to run it again. Thornton is going to be tripped up. Got a penalty flag late. Probably a holding call. Normally when the flag is thrown in that direction. Yep, it's going to be against Hobbton. That's going to move it back. So with a minute 35 to play, we can already see some of the Maroon Devil fans headed for the parking lot to try to beat the crowd out onto the highway here. So again, a great crowd on hand here tonight. We hope a lot of folks will come back and have an even bigger crowd this Friday when the Maroon Devils will be playing at home against either Union or Elkin. As you listen to this game, I'm sure you'll know who we will play Friday. Of course, a lot of folks looking ahead, but as Coach Rod White will tell you, you have to play them one game at a time. Can't look to December 11 yet, but you can definitely put it on your calendar and plan on it. December 11th, 12 noon. That's the State 1A championship game in Raleigh at Carter-Finley Stadium. Back to throw now. It's going to be Thornton down the middle in traffic. It's going to be, it's intercepted again. It's going to be, looks like Jason Boston. Boston brings it back to the 47-yard line. That snuffs out any final attempt at scoring by Hobbton here tonight. Swain 40. 31-7, the Devils get the ball back, and now we can run out the clock with a minute two to play. And again, a lot of Maroon Devil fans would like to be at Carter-Finley Stadium December 11. We would have the biggest crowd of the year for Carter-Finley Stadium if we make it to the State 1A championship. So now Cody White comes out of the lineup, so now a lot of new faces in. Cody White gets a great round of applause. Also coming out is going to be Josh Anthony, Eric Stevenson, among others. And Hobbton wants a time here with a minute to go. All right, fans, let's hope that's the last timeout. I mean, and now Scotty McMahon just hits a knee. So now we'll just have to do that another time or two, and the Maroon Devils will be ready to move on. Great night tonight running the football for Cody White. 22 carries, 177 yards. And Cody White having a great, great night tonight.
Cody hit 207 at Murphy.
Second down now. Doesn't matter what down it is. All we have to do is snap the ball. This could be the final play of the ball game. So the official's there. So now I think that's our last snap, fans, as the Maroon Devils start to take the field here. And the fans begin to celebrate. The horns are blowing. The cowbells are ringing. And the Devils move on. The State 1A semifinals up next is going to be played right here at Swain County Memorial Stadium Friday night as the Devils knock down Hobbton 31-7.
Hey, congratulations.
Thank you. I appreciate it, kids. The history just came pouring out. The more we talked to the kids about it this week, the more excited they became, the more intense they became, and they just felt like it was their mission right now to see what they could do with this bunch.
Well, what did you think when you're going into the locker room up 24-0? You played a great, great first half. What did you tell the guys at halftime?
Well, we were just going to, trying to make sure that our players understood that this ball game was still not out of, it's still in question. Anytime you're playing a team with that kind of speed, that kind of execution, anything can happen at any given time. So we just wanted to make sure that we didn't start turning the ball over, shooting ourselves in the foot, which we did some of in the second half, but we were able to overcome it.
Well, in the second half, kind of a cruise control type game. You played with a 7-7. What's your feelings watching the second half?
Well, we weren't as they were doing some different things. They had made some adjustments, some do-or-die type of adjustments there at halftime, and having some success with it. And my stupidity hurt us more than anything, not understanding it there for a while. And they drove the ball down there and scored on us. And we kind of got it worked out down there among ourselves and made some adjustments with the kids. And then they started to bring it on back up then.
Defensively, Kevin and I were watching that ball game. That's one of the most dominating defensive performances I think I've seen in the 10 years I've been here.
Well, you'd like to think that you could shut them out or hold them, but right now the most important thing to us is a team effort. And defensively, the kids understood their offense about as well as any, because for the last 4 weeks we have seen the wing tee offense. Now, we hadn't seen that kind of speed, which was something we worked on during the week about getting their tempo up and keeping it up, and trying to get them to maintain that type of tempo every time the ball snapped, because their quickness was it's deceiving. But out there on that grass, it's not. They were making some quick cuts, and we were going to try to force them to that 12th player out there, that white stripe that runs down that sideline, and let them run out of room. And hopefully they couldn't get the corner turned on us. And early in the ball game, that's pretty much what the kids did. And then force them to try to throw the football upfield like they did, and try to pick a few of them off.
If you're going to strip the dream season, obviously you want to be undefeated in the regular season, and you want to play well in the playoffs as you have. But then you'd like to be able to do a couple of things that's kind of been gnawing at you. That's one of your words.
Yeah.
You beat a team that's owned you, that's been 2-0, and now next week you get the team that eliminated you last year in the semifinals. I mean, that's almost too good to be true.
Well, it is, and we talked about that. Talked about fate, being, as a coach and as a team. These kids, this group of seniors, the past two seasons, being eliminated by one team and then having an opportunity to play the other team that eliminated them as juniors. I don't know what you call it, fate or how the cards are dealt or whatever. But our players understand that there's, we've got to take this thing 1 week at a time, and a win's a win. If it's ugly, it's ugly. If it's clean, it's clean. And this time of the year, there is no tomorrow for the loser.
Well, last year when we played Elkin at Elkin, the teams were pretty equal.
Right.
But they had a lot of seniors on that team that made big plays. I know you know a little bit about that team, and you're going to learn more about them this week. But how do we match up with them this year?
Well, I'll be honest with you. Other than knowing them from last year and the kids they had coming back, their skill level is right up there with Hobbton's, and they'll be better. They'll be better, I think, as far as all-around team size, team speed, and experience. They were able in a lot of football games last year to play a lot of those juniors and sophomores who are now leading them. And any team, Coach Grissom coaches up there, they're going to be very well coached. They're going to know what they're doing. And he does a great job of taking the talent, the player-level talent that he has, and utilizing it, whether it be the speed on the corner, throwing the football upfield. He knows how to use that.
Well,
So that's what we're up against, I know. Without even, I've not even seen them on tape, but we'll take care of that tomorrow.
Well, congratulations on this win, and good luck in next week's game. We'll talk to you next Friday night as the Elkin Buckin Elks comes to town.
Well, I appreciate it, and thank all the folks, and I'd like to thank all the fans. What a showing tonight. That was unbelievable. A great holiday weekend. First cool night we've had here in the mountains, and it was our fan support was unbelievable. It was quite deafening at times.
All right, well, thanks, Coach, and again, we'll talk to you next Friday night.
Thank you.
All right, that's Coach Rod White of the Maroon Devils, who are now 3-0 in the playoffs.
Continuing on the postgame show tonight, the Swain High Maroon Devils with a great win over the Hobbton Wildcats. It's kind of a dream season. You couldn't have written a better script. Hobbton had beaten us two in a row before coming into tonight's game. We got redemption in this game. The Elkin Bucking Elks are going to be coming to Swain County Memorial Stadium this Friday night. As you know, Elkin eliminated our Swain High Maroon Devils 24-22 last season in the State 1A semifinals, a game that probably cost Swain County High School a state championship. This Friday, redemption time again. Revenge Chapter 2 as our Devils take on Elkin. We hope you'll be here.